Paranormal Radio's Cryptid Tales. My name is Amber Beckrud, and today we are going to be talking about one of my fiance's favorite UFO mysteries, which was a big request of hers. So let's dive on into it. This one today comes courtesy of the Rendlesham Forest incident. Now, this incident is still very widely unknown, and it is pretty darn cool. For those of you who don't know, Rendlesham Forest is located in the county of Suffolk, about 8 miles or 13 kilometers east of Ipswich. Now, this is in England, of course. For those of you who need a little bit further of a blip over the pond into the map, but that's not where we get weird. Rendlesham Forest covers about 5.8 square miles or 15 kilometers squared of. It consists of multiple different plants as well as wetlands and is a generally large area. Now, the incidents that happened in this lovely, lovely little forest happened back in December of 1980. So let's go to day one. On December 26th of 1980, around 3 a.m., it was reported that a security patrol near the east gate of RAF Woodbridge saw mysterious lights descending into the nearby Rendlesham Forest. These lights had been attributed by astronomers to pieces of natural debris falling from the sky and were seen burning up as a fireball over southern England at the time. Servicemen initially thought it was a downed aircraft, not knowing about the astronomers' version of this story, and so they went to the forest to investigate. Now, of course, upon entering the forest and investigating the area, they saw, according to the memo, a glowing metallic object covered in lights. Now, that doesn't sound like any debris that I know of. As they attempted to approach this object, it seemed to move through the trees at a quick speed, and the animals in a nearby farm went into a complete frenzy. Now, I don't know any debris that has flown over any place that has been able to get up and continue to move that is just debris. One of the servicemen then later on claimed to have come in contact with a craft of unknown origin, although that was never actually publicized and confirmed by the service at the time. Shortly after 4 o'clock, the police were called to the scene, but upon arrival, the only lights that they said that they could see were of the Orford Lighthouse, which were way far away on the coast. After daybreak on the morning of December 26th, the servicemen returned to the area to investigate in daylight. Upon arrival, they found 3 impressions in the ground in the shape of a triangle, as well as burn marks on the ground, broken branches on nearby trees, therefore further solidifying that something did in fact fall and land in this area. The only strange thing is that it was no longer there at all. At 10:30 in the morning, the police were called again and they were shown the impressions on the ground and they decided, hey, it could have been made by an animal. So it got moved along. Georgina Bruni also apparently in her book called You Can't Tell the People published a photo of the supposed impressions that had been taken on the morning of the first sighting. Fast forward 2 whole days to December 28th of 1980, the deputy base commander visited the site of the strange occurrence and went back with the servicemen. They took radiation readings of the depressions in the ground and the surrounding area using a military-grade radar system, and although they recorded 0.07 mph, in other regions they also detected 0.03 to 0.04 mph and around the background level. So it had gone up a little bit. Now, furthermore, they detected a similar small burnt over half about a mile away from the landing site. It was during that investigation that another flashing light was seen in the direction of a farmhouse, but that was also in the same direction as the lighthouse on the coast that was seen a little bit further to the east. So it was kind of hard to tell at first glance where it came from. Now, of course, later, according to the report, three star-like lights were seen in the sky, two to the north and one to the south at 10 degrees. And it was said that the brightest of these hovered in the sky for about 2 to 3 hours, occasionally protruding a beam of light down to the ground. Astronomers wrote this off as just a bright star. And that's literally all we know about what happened in Rendlesham Forest. Nobody has said anything else at all. It is still a complete and utter mystery, and the radiation levels also are a mystery as to why they even went up by that much to begin with. Now, of course, like any UFO sighting, this has all been chalked up to just being a hoax. Oh yes, that is right. This one has become known as a hoax as well, but that might not be the case. I want to know what you guys think, because why would somebody, especially a government organization, go through so much trouble to create a UFO sighting if there wasn't, a UFO sighting? It all seems a little fishy to me, and of course, that's where you guys come in. So let me know down below, what do you think is the strangest part about the whole Rendlesham Forest experience and incident? Do you think it was faked? Do you think it was real? Do you think the police are hiding something, or the government hiding something? Or is it just another tall tale? This one I'm really excited for you guys to chime in on, and I can't wait to read your comments down below. That is it for me today, and I cannot wait to see you in the next video. A huge shout out to Ron Bumblefoot Thal for all of our music here on Spaced Out Radio, and of course, don't forget to check out my social media as well as all of Spaced Out Radio's social media, and I will see you in the next episode.